Well, good morning. God bless you this morning. God keep this morning. Thank you for tuning on to me once again. As always, praise God. God bless you. I want to share with you out of Zechariah chapter 7. It talks about a call to justice and mercy. A call to justice and mercy. Anyway, I want to start here. Zechariah chapter 7. You know, basically talk about, you know, when God's trying to tell you something, he's talking to you all about something, and, you know, giving you a message in the other world that some people just don't want to hear. They want to plug their ear, they don't want to hear, stuff like that. But I'm going to go ahead and read. And it also talks about, you know, the Bible in Matthew chapter 7, it said, don't judge. Do not judge others. But in this book, in Zechariah, it talks about that you can judge fairly. That's what it say also. But I'm going to go ahead and read. Zechariah chapter 7. I'm reading on my NLT Bible. A call to justice and mercy. Then I'm going to read about happiness a little later on after this. It says, on December 7th of the fourth year of King Darius' reign, another message came to Zechariah from the Lord. The people of Bethel had sent Sherezer along with their attendant to seek the Lord's favor. They were to ask this question of the prophet and the priest at the temple of the Lord of Heaven Armies. Should we continue to mourn and fast each summer on the anniversary of the temple destruction as we have done for so many years? The Lord of Heaven Armies sent me this message in reply. Say to your people and your priests, during these 70 years of exile, when you fast and mourned it in the summer and in early autumn, it says what is really for me that you were fasting, and even now in your holy festival are you eating and drinking just to please yourself? It says, isn't this the same message the Lord proclaimed through the prophet in years past when Jerusalem and the town of Judah were bursting with peoples? With the Negev and the foothill of Judah were well populated. Then this message came to Zechariah from the Lord. This is what the Lord of Heaven Army says, judge fairly. That's what it said, judge fairly. You know, Matthew 7, it said, do not judge others. But this says, judge fairly. So you can judge fairly. You don't judge somebody that you don't judge on talking about somebody that you don't know or don't know nothing about. You know, judge somebody for what it looked like and don't even know what's going on. Judging what you heard, you know, and didn't see for yourself or wasn't about you. You're judging, doing these kind of other kind of things. But it says here, judge fairly. And it says, and show mercy and kindness to one another. It says, do not oppress widows or offering for foreigners and the poor, and do not scheme against each other. And that's also in the book of Isaiah chapter 58 verse 6 through 8. It says, your ancestors refused to listen to this message. They stumbling turned away and put their fingers in their ear to keep from hearing. Just imagine they could put their finger in their ear, you know, because they don't want to hear. They keep it, they just don't want to hear. They put their finger all up in their ear, you know, don't want to hear. Don't want to hear what was said or what was heard. They don't want to hear. In verse 12 it says, they not hear the instruction or the message that the Lord of Heaven Armies has sent them by his spirit through the early prophet. That is why the Lord of Heaven Armies was so angry with them. Because they don't want to hear it. They don't want to know nothing. And also, that's also in the book of Jeremiah chapter 17 verse 1. It says, since they refuse to listen when I called to them, I could not listen when they called to me. It's like, since you won't listen to God, he ain't gonna listen to you. When you call on him, it's like he ain't gonna listen to you. It says, I would not listen when they called to me, says the Lord of Heaven Armies. As with a whirlwind, I scattered them among the distant nation where they live as strangers. Their land became so desolate that no one even traveled through it. They turned their pleasant land into a desert. And that's also in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 64. And I also want to share talking to you about your happiness. Happiness, praise God. I had on a shirt, one that talks about don't be angry, be happy. It said don't be angry, be happy. And this is somebody that seen it and they said, well, I like that shirt. I said, well, thank you. You know, so I said, it is what it is. Don't be angry. Angry for what? Be happy. You know, she says, I like that shirt. I'm like, well, thank you. Anyway, you know, now, anyway, I'm going to read about happiness. You know, Psalm 37, verse 4 and 5. It says, delight thyself also in the land, and he shall give there the desire of thy heart. Commit thy ways unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And Psalm 63, verse 4 and 5 says, thus will I bless thee while I live. I will lift up my hand in thy name. My soul shall be satisfied as with morrows and fatness, and my mouth shall praise thee with joyful lips. Your joyful lips. Psalm 64, verse 10 says, the righteous shall be glad in the Lord and shall trust in him, and all the upright in heart shall glory. It says, shall glory. Upright in heart shall glory. And Psalms 84, verse 11 says, for the Lord God is a sun and shed. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good things will he withhold from them that walketh uprightly. In Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 13, it says, happy is a man that findeth wisdom, and a man that getteth understanding. In John chapter 10, verse 10, it says, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and destroy. I am come, he says, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. In John chapter 13, verse 17, it says, if ye know these things, happy are ye if ye do them. You know, so how you gonna do them? You not do them and be happy, do them. Happy is, it says, happy are ye if ye do them. Ye mean you. Happy are you if you do them. Praise God. And God bless you. Happy is you if you do them. If you don't want to do it, then you no longer expect to be happy. You want to be sad, don't want to smile. You're not going to be like going to places and stuff like that. Just no particular place. Just out. Just whatever, at a store or a gas station or whatever, or a mall or a theater, whatever you name it. You know, and sometimes in the house of the Lord building, you know, some people just have that look, like that just sad look. I don't know if it's just the expression, it is just how they look. But they don't even smile. It's like good morning, hello, they be like, good morning. You know, it's like that's it's like no smile. And I'm like, wow, it's not no joy. And what's wrong? You need to be thankful that God woke you up this morning. You know, somebody couldn't be here. You know, and you know, they'd be like just looking sad, like I said something wrong or something crazy to them. And I feel like, wow, what a happiness that, what a joy are you at? I mean, it's like, wow. I mean, it's like, I don't know. I mean, I guess you have to keep the joy on me. I mean, if people don't want to do their dues, I have to do my due. They want to look sad. They don't want to be thankful that God woke them this morning. They might be going through some issues, whatever. Whatever the reason it is, they probably lost a loved one, their mom, their dad, their best friend, their uncle, their cousin, or something, you know. But it's like, looking sad is not going to bring them back. You know, I'm pretty sure. I mean, I lost some peoples in my life, too. You know, but it's not going to keep me down forever. You know, it's like when it did happen, it's like, and I still have to keep my joy. It's like, me being sad and me not want to eat or doing crazy stuff is not going to bring nobody back to life. You know, it's like God got me here for a purpose. I'm still here. I got to do what I do. Still do my dues. Praise God. That's why I would say, you know, it's just a spirit thing. You know, you got to get a hold to the word and do the will of God. So whatever go come your way, whatever you're facing, whatever, you know, things probably just came up. You know, it might be a shocking tragedies or surprise or secret or something. But, you know, at the same time, you still got to have a strong hold to the world, you know, and just know that God is here with me. God is here for me. You know, nobody's not going to be against me because I know God is for me. You know, in spite of whatever goes on, yes, things happen and everything, but at the same time, you have to make up your mind, or are you going to stop living because something else happened to somebody, you know, that don't mean you stop living. You still here. You still got to keep on going. You know, of course things happen every day. I understand, of course things happen every day. But well, what are you going to make out of it? Are you going to drag yourself down, you know, stay down because little things or whatever, probably be a big thing that happened? I mean, it's like, what are you going to do? Are you going to lift yourself back up? Are you going to get yourself back strong and order? Or are you just going to stay down and let the devil win? Because the devil want to tear you down anyway. Are you going to let the devil win? Are you going to say, no, I know things happen. You know, you cried, you cheered, you shed, whatever. Your tears and everything, whatever happened, whatever tragedies happened, you know. But at the same time, you get back up. Get yourself back in order. Get yourself back strong and ask God to keep you strong. You know, no matter what comes your way. And like, you're going to be sick. You're going to know how to, you know. It's like you're going to know how to keep strong no matter what comes your way. You know, so I'll be like, it's like I was looking for one job, you know, if I said one job, then another job called. It's like one job or whatever, fire, or a business took over the place, or whatever. It's like, you think I'm let that get me down? And I know who my God is. I still got to praise him and serve him. I'm still going to do what I do. Regardless, yeah, things happen and everything. It's like, I'm going to tear myself down or stay down because something happened. You don't know what I mean, because I know who I am in Christ Jesus. I gotta stay in faith. I gotta stay in the spirit. And I just know my God. Because when you know who you are in Christ Jesus, it's like nothing won't bother you. You know, you can be like thinking like, wow. But you know what? It'd be like, God has something better. Always remember, God has something better for you. Nothing just don't happen on accident. God knows what he's doing at all times. You may not think he knows what he's doing. You may not think so. You may be like, well, I had it going on, this and that. You know, things happen for a reason. You know, sometimes God want to, you know, do some research on you. You know, if you're going to stay tuned, or you're going to get in the world, you're going to do what you say do, or you're going to trust in his world and meditate on what they said or whatever. You go, God already said you whatever you ask for. He'll provide your every need according to his riches. Whatever you ask, you shall have if you just believe. You know, hold on to your faith. Don't stop it. Don't quit. And sometimes God tests you to see what you're going to do. Sometimes he can move some stuff out your way just to test you and see if you're still going to be in the word. You're going to still walk in faith. You're going to still love one another. You're going to still do what our first calls you to do. Stay on course. Don't stop. Don't quit. You know, do your dues. You know, I mean, are you going to give up and stop? You don't do certain things. Number one, stop going to the house of the Lord. You know, just giving up. You know, this ain't supposed to happen. Here I am doing this, I'm doing it, and this ain't supposed to happen. But maybe it's not. Maybe it's not supposed to happen. But God, like I always say, God knows what he's doing. You know, things happen for a reason. Nothing just don't happen. Praise God. Anyway, I'm praying for each and every last one, in spite of what you're going through. I mean, you know, that's why I be like, God already know what's best for me. You know, even though it may not look like it or may not feel like it, but he knows what he's doing. He knows what's best. He do know what he's doing. Even though you may not think so, it's not about you. It's about what he said. It's about what he knows. Praise God. And that's what it's about. What he knows what's best for you. You know, we may want some stuff, desire something, and you know, sometimes you'll get it. But you know, at the same time, it may not last. It may last for a short time, but it may not last, you know, long as what God have for you, you know, in your life to last. You know, what he gives to you, in other words. However that go. But anyway, God bless you. God bless you. God keep you. All I know is God is good all the time. Even though when things don't look so good, things happen. You know, he didn't say trial and tribulation wasn't going to happen. You know, he just want to know. Sometimes it can be like a test for you. It's a test for me. A test for anybody. Just see if you're going to stay on the world. Still love one another. Still do what's good. Still do what's right. Or we going to fall short and let that devil interfere. And, you know, and stop our blessing. And then we don't even know how close our blessing is. That's why I said it'd be a test. And it could be your blessing at the same time. Your blessing could be closer than what you think. You know, sometimes people just mess up stuff. And then like, wow, I would have had that. If I didn't do this and do that, I would have all this stuff. So you're just waiting on a God, waiting on the Lord. And God, I know what you know is best for me. You know, at the same time, I'm going to keep on trusting you. I'm going to keep on standing in the word, reading and doing the will of God. You know, I'm still going to praise your name. Hallelujah. I'm still going to thank you for what I do have. You know, are you going to still stay in faith and trust in God no matter what? Because he's going to bring you out. He already see you going through things. He already see you going through whatever you're going through. He's going to bring you out. You know, you just keep on doing what you do, standing in good faith and good courage and holding on to the word and doing, living and loving one another, helping somebody. Hallelujah. Not being selfish, not having that love on you and all this crazy stuff. What the world do? They don't want to smile. They don't want to speak. They don't want to have this attitude. They want to get smart. You know, I was at the house of the Lord Sunday. I was at the house of the Lord and everything. And it was like that Sunday night. I was dropping my daughter off to the youth. They was having a youth church, you know, that night. But it wasn't no adult church. And I was like, wow. And then the lady, she was standing. And I kept on circling around. I'm like, because the door wasn't open. And there's somebody was in the car. The lady was standing out the car talking to somebody else. So, you know, looked at them and I passed by. And I'm like, I wonder if they're waiting on for the youth service. And so I went around again. I'm like, instead of be asking the first time, I didn't ask for the first time. I was wanting to go check it out and go around the block and see some other doors open at the church. But they wasn't. So I came back around the corner and the lady was still standing out the car. I mean, they was talking. I didn't want to interfere with them anyway. They was talking. So when the second time I rolled right by them, and my daughter said, just ask the lady what time this daughter is, or they having it tonight, the youth service, and you know, for the teenager and everything, Tina, for the kids, the youth service. And so I said, excuse me, if they having the youth service tonight, she said, yes, they're gonna have it right there. And then she gonna say, well, if you would have asked me the first time, you know, I could have told you. And I looked at her. I said, I'm a stay in the spirit. I'm a stay in the spirit because I'm like, huh? If you would have came around, you know, I seen you go around the first, you would have asked the first time, I could have told you something to go. I'm like, I said, okay, thank you. I said, thank you anyway, thank you. And so I don't hear all that love, that smartness and everything, you know. I feel she kind of got smart, you know. I'm like, they was talking, I don't want to interfere. And they were like they was in deep conversations. So I was wondering, I don't want to interfere, you know, but people's out here with this state where I'm in, you know, they so rude. They just don't care. They interrupt you, they cut in. I mean, it could be not just because of this, it could be anywhere. Some people they just don't have no respect, and they just cut in, butt in, and cutting in any conversation. You could be talking to somebody and somebody could be all like pissing, yeah, and you don't even, you're like, where this person come from? I ain't talking to this person. This person would be all butting in and cutting in while at the same time you talking to somebody, and you'd be like looking, you're like, I'm talking to this person. Where you come from? Well, see, I'm not the type to do that, to be cutting in or butting in or, you know, listen to conversation, then I'm saying something. But it's like, wow, if she was in the word of God, you know, staying in spirit, not letting that smart talk, you know, because people go to church, that don't mean nothing. You know, they can go to church, they go to church all they want to, but they're not in the word of God, doing the word of God, you know, and know how to treat one another, know how to talk to one another, you know. You know, I mean, if I say to myself, they don't know nothing. They just going to church. They don't know the world. They don't come in because it's like it's just a different for me, because I know, and I thank God for changing me, because I know the way I used to be, I would have said something stupid. I really would. I would say something crazy. You know, if God didn't change me from where I was before. But anyway, I just said, okay. I mean, you know, it's like I'm trying to hold my hold my anger at the same time, but it was like, you know, okay, she had to go to an extra yard, a 9-yard, whatever you want to call it, in her words, in other words, if you would have came down here, then I'm like, boy, okay, thank you, thank you, Jesus, thank you, you know. Praise God. Anyway, God bless you. God keep you. I just hope that you all know what I'm talking about. You know, sure. Because people just don't, they don't have no respect. They just don't cut in, button in. You know, A and B conversations. Like, see your way out. I'm not talking to you. I'm just, or A and B, I'm talking to this person. And before you know it, somebody, yeah. You know, I'm like, it's like, where you come from? I'm not even talking to you. I'm talking to this person, you know, and people just pitch in. I'm like, I'm not used to all that. I mean, I just like to wait. If they ain't talking to me, then, you know, times the thing got me in, if I ain't involved, I'm not gonna be like kind of compensated or be on that level anyway. You know, I just, you know, can hear it, but I ain't gotta respond. But people, they just don't, I don't know, people just people, I guess. Anyway, bless them, bless them, bless them. God bless them. Let's pray for them, pray for them, pray for them, and leave it alone. I mean, I have to pray for myself, for God to keep me together too. Because, I mean, wow. It's crazy. Anyway, Heavenly Father, God bless you. I pray, Lord, to be with you and keep you and lead you and protect you. And I pray that you do the will of God for your life. The one that's just going to church and not, don't even want to give God no time of the day, just only on Sunday. I pray the name of Jesus, that it will change. I pray that you will just have God and see God every day in your life. You know, meditate, do the will of God for your life, live it, love one another, respect one another, in Jesus' name. God bless you all today, and I rebuke every sickness and every disease. Somebody may not be feeling good. Somebody may be sick. I don't know. You could know somebody that's sick and not feeling good. I pray the name of Jesus. Lord, just heal and touch right where they hurt. Heal and touch right where they pain, in Jesus' name. Whether it's low back pain or a side hurt, your leg, your foot, your hips, I don't know, your arms, your neck, your shoulders. I pray, Lord, just release the pain in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. You may have a mind-brain headache. I pray, Lord, just fix it, remove it. All the pain in Jesus' name. And I just rebuke all that high blood pressure, low blood pressure in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. I rebuke sugar diabetes and all that cancer and heart attack, heart disease. I rebuke all that in Jesus' name. But whatever it is, in Jesus' name, I know my God is a healer. He's not a killer. He wants you well. He wants you healed. And by his stripes, you are healed. If you receive and believe it right now, in Jesus' name, I pray. God bless you today and God keep you as well as every day. In Jesus' name. And I rebuke every demon and devil trying to stop you. Whatever situation, whatever you're trying to go to, whatever you're trying to do in life. You may be looking for a job. I don't know what you're doing. I just pray, Lord, just hold them doors open. Keep them doors open for you in Jesus' name. And I pray the one that be interview you or whoever it is, supervisor, manager, I pray there be a yes in their spirit, yes in their heart to hire you as soon as possible in Jesus' name. The same day, glory be to God, and God bless you, and God keep you, in spite of what you're going through, in spite of what nobody said, in spite of what somebody said. You rebuke them in Jesus' name. Stay up. Be blessed. Keep going forward. Don't look back. No matter what happened yesterday, let yesterday go. Let yesterday be yesterday. Today is another day, and I pray you move forward and be blessed, because your blessing's up ahead of you. In Jesus' name, God bless you, and God keep you. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Amen, amen. Glory be to God. Amen, amen, amen. And I pray the Lord to just strengthen you and keep you strong wherever you're weak. I pray the Lord just make you strong, keep you strong. In Jesus' name I pray. Glory be to God. Amen, amen. Glory be to God. Amen. I serve an awesome God. Yes, I do. And I thank you, Jesus, for the change. I thank you, Jesus, for the change. I pray, Lord, you just bless that lady, that man, that boy, and, the girl, and that girl, in Jesus' name, to respect one another. Glory be to God. No matter how old or young, respect you, respect. Respect don't come in a way. Just respect one another, in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. Amen. Until next time, remember, God loves you, and so do I. Be blessed. Take care. Until next time, God say the same. See you later.